Students, this is NCERT problem 2.17 from page number 57 of Structure of Atom, right? So let's read the statement. What is the total number of orbitals associated with principal quantum number n equal to 3? Okay, so you are having the value of principal quantum number. That means you are having the value of orbit and you have to find the number of orbitals associated with this orbit, right? So for this, first, we'll see a formula that you can use in your competitive exams and find the value directly, right? So that will be number of orbitals equal to n square, right? So n square means the value of n is 3, right? So you have to take the square of 3, that will be 9. That means with n equal to 3, you are having 9 orbitals. Now, we will do this question in detail. Okay, so first of all, this n is orbit, right? So, principal quantum number that is n, tell us about the number of orbits, or you can also call it as shell, right? And now next one is azimuthal quantum number, right? Now this azimuthal quantum number is denoted by L and its value is 0 to n minus 1, right? So this tells us about the number of subshells. Now the last one, that is magnetic quantum number . It is denoted by M and its value is minus L2 plus L. Now this will tell you about the number of orbitals present in this value, right? So now let's start our question. So we are having N equal to 3, right? For this case, the value of L will be L equal to 0 to n minus 1, 3 minus 1, right? So 0 to 3 minus 1 means 0 to 2, right? So the possible values of L will be 0, 1 and 2. Now let's assign the name to these subshells, right? So if I am having L equal to 0, right? So this subshell is known as S, right? If I'm having L equal to 1, this subshell is known as P. And if L equal to 2, this will be known as D orbitals, right? So now let's see the number of orbitals over here. Now we are having the value of L. If we are having L equal to 0, in this case, M equal to also 0. And this orbital is known as S orbital. That means we are having only one orbital in this S subshell, right? Now next, if L equal to 1, in this case M equal to minus 1 to plus 1, right? Minus 1, 0, plus 1. Now this is P orbital, right? Now in these P orbitals, if M is minus 1, this orbital will be px. If M is 0, this orbital will be py. If M equal to plus 1, this orbital will be pz. That means we are having 3 orbitals in this P subshell, right? So you can write 3 over here, right? Now last one, that is if L equal to 2, in this case M will be minus 2, 2 plus 2, right? So minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. If M is minus 2, this orbital is dxy. If M is minus 1, this orbital is dyz. If M is 0, dzx. If M is plus 1, dx square minus y square. And if m is plus 2 d z square, right? So in this case, in d subshell, we are having 5 orbitals, right? So you can write over here this d xy, d yz, d zx, d x square minus y square, and last one d z square, right? So number of orbitals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you can write 5 orbitals are present in d subshell, right? So now let's count the number of orbitals. These are 5 plus 3, that will be 8. 8 plus 1, 9 orbitals are present in orbit 3.